कॉमर्स आईटी इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स कम्युनिकेशन गवर्नमेंट ऑफ तेलंगाना. हिज एक्सीलेंसी मिस्टर मोहम्मद सुलेमान कक्कर, कॉन्सुल जनरल ऑफ द इस्लामिक रिपब्लिक ऑफ अफगानिस्तान हैदराबाद, एंड मिस्टर सफीकुला अतिया, सीईओ ऑफ अफगानिस्तान चेंबर ऑफ कॉमर्स, हुज जॉइंड अस वर्चुअली अलॉन्ग विद हिज टीम. गुड आफ्टरनून टू यू ऑल. The past few months have been challenging for all of us, we know, and also, sir, we have seen decline in the visits of the foreign dignitaries, and we have been conducting a lot of webinars, B2B meetings online. And I would like to specially thank Mr. Ranjan and also His Excellency for encouraging us to conduct this program physically. So thank you so much for this encouragement. And today we have almost 40 members who have joined us, and they are all primarily from agro food, pharmaceutical, engineering, construction, chemical products, who are keen to expand their business network and also explore newer markets. So we urge all the members to please then interact with the team. Also, we have from the consulate office. Can you get up so they can? So she's from the consulate office, and I request members to then interact with her. Mahati.
Hello, hi.
Sorry, Mahati, Miss Mahati. Before we begin the session, for few of the new members who have joined, we would like to show you a short film about a 1 minute promotional video of FTCCI.
The largest business organization of Telangana state, with a legacy of excellence. The voice of the industry, representing the interests of 25,000 businesses of all sizes, sectors and regions. Empowering trade through advocacy, solution and standard setting. Opening new avenues for unprecedented growth. Laying the foundation for an industrial transformation in the state of Telangana. Now, poised for the next century and beyond. The Federation of Telangana Chambers of Commerce and Industry, FTCCI. Together, let's rewrite the vision for a progressive future.
We'll begin the session, and before that, I request Mr. Bhaskar Reddy to welcome with a plant to Mr. Jayesh Ranjan. I request Mr. Anil Agarwal, Senior Vice President, to welcome with a plant to His Excellency Mr. Mohammad Suleiman Kakarji. So, Afghan Chamber representative, they are on virtually. So, we welcome you, sir, to this seminar. We also recognize the presence of Mr. Syed Mohammad Ibrahim Khil, Vice Consul of Consulate Office. Ms. Mehati from the Consulate Office, Mr. Murli from Pharmaceutical Export Promotion Council, and Mr. Akhilesh from FICCI Telangana State Council. So now I request Mr. K. Bhaskar Reddy, President of FTCCI, to give his welcome address.
Mr. Jayesh Ranjan, IAS Principal Secretary, Industries, Commerce, Information Technology, Electronics and Communication, Government of Telangana. Your Excellency, Mr. Mohammad Suleiman Kakar. Mr. Shafiqullah Fatai, CEO, Afghanistan Chamber of Commerce and Investment. Mr. Anil Agarwal, Senior Vice President. Mr. Rajendra Agarwal, Chair, International Trade Committee. Khyati, CEO. Participants, ladies and gentlemen, very good afternoon to you all. It gives me great pleasure to welcome you all to this seminar on promotion of business between Afghanistan and Telangana state. My special welcome to Sri Jayesh Ranjanji, Your Excellency Mr. Muhammad Sulaiman Kakarji, and Mr. Shafiullah Tai. The theme of today's seminar is peace and stability through trade, and we believe that global cooperation and integration through expanded trade ties will contribute to the global stability and peace. So when we planned this seminar a few days back, we received few questions like, yeah, we are looking in newspapers, studying here and there, there is a disturbance in Afghanistan. These kind of questions have come. So that's when we decided this is all the more important to do this kind of a conference, where we promote that the theme itself is selected on that peace and stability through trade. And we strongly believe that people to people connect, economic ties, trade, these things will, even if any disturbances are there, this is the through medium with which we can address the concerns. And I strongly believe this is an excellent move. And when we coined this to both Mr. Jayesh Ranjanji and Your Excellency Mr. Muhammad Sulaiman Kakar, they were so open-minded and immediately they agreed and they said, yes, we will do it irrespective of what conditions, geopolitical development. But fortunately, past 1 week, we are seeing excellent improvement in the ground, and hopefully this conflict will resolve completely. And as expected, trade and commerce relationships will develop, particularly with Telangana state and Afghanistan. On behalf of FTCCI, we thank the Afghanistan government for opening the consulate office in Hyderabad to further the trade and other economic opportunities and expand trade between Afghanistan and South India. Thank you very much, Your Excellency. I think when we visited last month, thanks for the hospitality given at your consulate, and we open-heartedly welcome your presence in Hyderabad. And FTCCI is working very closely with consulate office in further strengthening the mutual relationship between India and Afghanistan. FTCCI also partnered with the consulate office in organizing 10-day food festival held in April 2021 at Hyderabad for the establishment of mutual interest of both India and Afghanistan. The festival was very well organized and attended by many participants. India and Afghanistan have strong relationship based on historical and cultural links. The bilateral relationship between India and Afghanistan have remained strong and friendly over the decades. Given the geographical proximity and historical linkages, India has been a natural trading partner for Afghanistan and is the largest market in South Asia for its products. To further enhance trade relations, and on the suggestion of Consulate General of Afghanistan, today FTCCI is entering into an agreement of cooperation with Afghanistan Chamber of Commerce and Investment, ACCI, and work towards promoting trade and business linkages. I warmly welcome, I think many of the our counterparts from ACCI are virtually logged in. Welcome, and whenever an opportunity, please visit Hyderabad, and when things are improved, even we will plan to visit Afghanistan. The Indian markets, especially Telangana, has been growing consistently, and there are great opportunities to expand trade and investment, particularly in the pharma, agro and food processing sector, information technology, tourism, logistics, energy and manufacturing sectors. Telangana has topped the ranking in ease of doing business in the country, thus demonstrating the commitment and dedication with which government of Telangana is working. We invite the Afghanistan government and companies to proactively partner in development projects and programs. These partnerships can help us reach new heights in our trade and commercial partnerships. I am confident that this seminar will help in further expanding the economic ties between our two countries, more particularly with the state of Telangana. I assure you our best cooperation in strengthening the trade relationship. We are confident that we will succeed together in overcoming this pandemic and building new partnership post-COVID. Once again, I welcome all the partners, trade partners, ACCI members, our members for joining today's seminar. And thank you very much, all of you.
Thank you, Mr. President. I now request Mr. Rajendra Agarwal, Chair, International Trade Committee, to give his introductory remarks.
Good afternoon, everyone. Respected dignitaries on the dais, Mr. Shafiqullah Ayati, CEO and member of Afghanistan Chamber of Commerce and Industry, ACCI, participants, ladies and gentlemen. I am delightful to welcome you all on the seminar, Promotion of Business Between Two Countries, Afghanistan and Telangana State. Afghanistan is a land of beauty, opportunity and investment. And we do hope that we will build a bridge between Afghanistan and India, especially in Telangana, for the establishing a platform for promotion of culture and trade. In a bid to stabilize Afghanistan economy, India is spending up development of Chabahar Port in Iran. That will result landlocked Afghanistan and Central Asia, using the Iranian port for to trade with India and other countries. Hyderabad is famous for its export of stunt jewelry, identified as sole product for promoting Hyderabad district as export hub, whereas the Afghanistan has a lot of gemstone deposits. Indian investments in mining can improve output and safety. Afghan gemstone can be used by Indian manufacturer for jewelry. Furthermore, Telangana can be destination for Afghan student to pursue higher education in reputable universities here in Hyderabad. Not only that, but we have three prominent Afghan cricket players, including Rashid Khan, playing for Sunrise India in Hyderabad team. The opening of consulate office in Hyderabad and closer cooperation between two chambers by way of signing of memorandum of understanding between the FTCCI and Afghanistan Chamber of Commerce and Investment, ACCI, will surely help in enhancing the trade between two countries, more particularly with the state of Telangana. We request the consulate office to regularly send us the trade inquiries and exhibition happening in Afghanistan to for circulation to our members of FTCCI. I once again welcome you all, and I am sure this seminar will give an opportunity the businessmen to know the development taken place in Afghanistan and the scope of establishing business cooperation, joint ventures, technology, import, and or making investment in Afghanistan, more particularly post-COVID era. Thank you very much, everyone.
Thank you. I now request Mr. Shafiqullah Atai, CEO of Afghanistan Chamber of Commerce and Investment, to address. And before he gives address, I request the participants who are representing the Afghan Chamber, maybe they can give a briefly introduction, name and the company which are the sector which they are representing.
Well, first of all, let me make a number of inquiries, and I would like to deliver my speech regarding to this about the movement of trade between Afghanistan and the state of India. Well, unfortunately,
we are able to hear. Please speak loudly, na? Or maybe mic. Yes, please.
It's okay now?
Yes.
Well, thank you. This is Shafiq Atai, Acting CEO of ACCI. One of the issues that has been raised by our colleague from the Dutch side regarding the participants over here, unfortunately, due to some misalignments that happened. Most of the people were who were expecting to have to be from different sectors. That has been all that happened since we had not a perception regarding this event. It was only, ceremony of signing a new understanding between ACCI and the Nagana state. That's why we would love to and like to have that B2B in Kerala after signing this meeting. Today's the individuals who are attending this conference with senior virtually, your ACCI or colleagues from different departments of ACCI. Inshallah, in the next future, we are going to have that B2B session. Mr. Jahish Ranjan, Principal Secretary of Industry and Commerce. Mr. Mohammad Saiman Carter, Council General of Afghanistan in Hyderabad. Ms. Haiti Navani, CEO of FTCCI. Mr. Baskir Reddy, President of FTCCI, leadership of FTCCI. Friends and colleagues who have been participated from the private sector of Srinagar State. It's an honor to be with you virtually in the promotion of business between Afghanistan and the Nagar State. I wish to thank our Council General and all stakeholders for organizing and hosting this conference. This is truly an appropriate sitting that brings together the leadership of two chambers to deliberate on how to build and shape a new era of cooperation, exchange ideas, and find new partners. At the outset, permit to give you a brief context about Afghanistan Chamber of Commerce and Industry, which has started 9 years ago. Currently, the chamber represents over 90% of the total Afghan workforce. ACCI is based in Kabul and operates in 27 provincial chambers around the country. Its CAM membership exceeds 65 global members and companies and 255 business unions, associations, and cooperatives who represent a vast majority of the total Afghan workforce in the country. ACCI has broad connection. We have signed 60 MOU with regional chambers and beyond, and have 15 business and giant chambers. And members of, we are members of SARC, CCI, APCCI, ICC Islamic Chambers. Furthermore, we are the only branching association through IRU for issuing the IR card in the country. And as well, we are the only organization to issue the certificate of provision to the Afghan products and groups. At the same time, we are a member of all relevant to the private sector of Afghanistan, high councils and committees of the government of Islamic Republic of Afghanistan. With India, with our brother country, we have a lot in common that makes us work together. And as a representative of the oldest and biggest chamber of Afghanistan, that play pivotal role in economic growth and attracting investment. We are committed to establish conducive and enabling business environment to business community of Afghanistan and the Nagar State through various platforms, holding business conferences, exhibitions, trade missions, and so forth. We have already signed MOUs with FICCI, India Business Group, IBG, and Indian Merchant Chambers, and vigorously conducting online B2B conference with tangible outcomes. To increase the trade volume and facilitate export, ACCI with other stakeholders, like GA Corridor, to India in 2017, which had a positive spiral order impact on bilateral relations. Now all saffron invited fish food are exported to this corridor. This organization strongly pushing with our government and international partner, specifically with USA, ID on how to solve trade barriers with India, which is the most importantly the transportation issue. We are landing our country to reach India and other markets beyond. We must cross Pakistan and regularly face with huge obstacles and challenges that, you know, most of our colleagues are aware of the kind of situation. And one of the great achievements during at least the last 5 years, we had the Chobaha, as I'll try later, achievement of India, Iran, and Afghanistan. But still, these achievements that could play a very pivotal and major role in enhancing the trade volume between Afghanistan and India is still facing and encountering a lot of challenges. One of the challenges are the banking issue that we are in discussions with having a partner in India to make this happen in order to solve the banking issue of while transacting amongst and while doing business in Java. In 2020, our total export to India was almost 405 million. Through here, according to it, was like 170 million. Fortunately, those companies registered. And one of the good news that we would like to resolve here, those companies are the current and ongoing reforms that has been taken forward by the government of Afghanistan and in coordination with the ACC, Afghanistan Chamber of Commerce. A lot of challenge has been elevated. A lot of things have been improved. Now, I think the companies we are registered and working with us. And in terms of packaging, they are well and nicely equipped and able to reach different markets. And they are now meeting eligible according to the current achievements and progresses that we have in packaging and packing. A few years of the companies we are exporting goods to other countries now. Now we are able to compete in the international markets. You can find Afghan fresh foods in USA, EU, Australia, South Asia, Middle Asia, and Gulf. Many fresh foods and resin food companies using high technologies and processing and packing. And really appreciate Afghan government for issuing the status certificate accepted to the world. To wrap up, this is very, which has more than 65 members, has intention to cooperate with Telangana State business by finding the Afghan partners. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you, Mr. Shafiqullah and his team for briefing us on the Afghanistan Chamber and the various initiatives taken by ACCI. Now we have the signing of MOU between FTCCI and ACCI in the presence of Mr. Jayesh Ranjan and Your Excellency Mr. Mohammad Suleiman Kakkar. The MOU is signed by Mr. Shafiqullah Atai, CEO of Afghanistan Chamber of Commerce and Industry, virtually, and Mr. K. Bhaskar Reddy, President from FTCCI, in the august presence of our chief guest, Mr. Jayesh Ranjan, Principal Secretary of Industries and Commerce, and Your Excellency, Mr. Mohammad Suleiman Kakkar, Consul General of Islamic Republic of Afghanistan. The MOU will be exchanged in the presence of our two guests today. Mr. Bhaskar Reddy will be giving a signed MOU to Your Excellency, Mr. Mohammad Suleiman Kakkarji. One copy to Mr. Jayesh Ranjanji, one copy to Mr. Suleiman Kakarji. Thank you. I now request Your Excellency Mr. Muhammad Suleiman Kakarji, Consul General of Islamic Republic of Afghanistan, to address the participants.
His Excellency Mr. Jayesh Ranjan, Principal Secretary, our dear friend Mr. Bhaskar Reddy, the new President of FTCCI, Madam Kyati Narvan, CEO of FTCCI, Mr. Rajendra Agarwal, the Chair of International Trade Committee, FTCCI, Dr. Kulkarni, and Mr. Shafiqullah Atai, the CEO of Afghanistan Chamber of Commerce and Investment, Mr. Said Muhammad Ibrahim Khil, Vice Counsel of the Consul General of the Islamic Republic of Afghanistan here in Hyderabad, Madam Mati, my dear colleague, the consulate, dear participants, Assalamu Alaikum, Namaste, good afternoon. Let me first thank FTCCI for organizing this wonderful seminar. And my thanks to Excellency Mr. Jayesh Ranjan for blessing this great event with his presence, despite he is being so busy. And let me also congratulate the FTCCI for their new leadership, Mr. Bhaskar and the Vice President, who have been recently elected as the new leadership. So we wish you all the best and successes in this chamber. Today is really a very important day for us all to see our witness signing of Memorandum of Understanding between the Chamber of Commerce and Investment of Afghanistan, Investment of Afghanistan, and also the Federation of Telangana Chamber of Commerce and Industries. Basically, as I understand, the main purpose of signing this MOU for both the chamber is to act together for promotion of trade between Telangana and Afghanistan. So we are connecting Telangana with Afghanistan. India, as a great country, is already connected with Afghanistan. South India is also having a great potential and important for furthering and expanding that connection through trade and through exchange of cultural programs. As you all know, Afghanistan is a great nation with natural resources, and we look forward for even more trade relation with India, especially with the spirit of Telangana in all the sectors, including IT, infrastructure, mining, communication, education, energy, transport, agriculture, pharmacy, healthcare. From now on, I believe the two chambers will work together for the purpose of promoting business cooperation between the business communities in Afghanistan and in Telangana. The chambers, I'm sure, will exchange market information, which are necessary for companies, enterprises, and organizations investing and operating in one or both countries. As Mr. Agarwal said, the consulate will share information. Obviously, we will share information whenever there is information available and of interest to friends and companies here. So basically, the chambers will also be doing the same thing, and we will be also facilitating sharing that information. So information on the tariff, on the bilateral trade agreement that exists between Afghanistan and India. And I forgot my colleagues to mention Mr. Shafiqullah Atai and his colleagues there in Kabul. So my dear friends are there. I see their handsome faces. I'm so glad, the bright and shining faces. and they are overcoming all the challenges they are facing. And thanks for the information you share. And I'm sure from now on, you will be sharing more information with the chamber here so they can share it with their members. And that's how we will be able to establish links and ties and connection between the business community, two places. I also believe that two chambers will plan to organize seminars, symposiums, conferences, workshops, meetings, involving the business communities and cooperation of competent authorities, in cooperation of the competent authorities. They will also take possible measure for the further development of bilateral economic relations by involving in this process the wide range of actors like governmental and non-governmental organizations, as well as the companies and enterprises for different economic sectors. I believe both chambers will work together and plan organizing exhibitions, fairs, and informational events, and create necessary conditions for the active participation of companies, enterprises, and organizations from Telangana and Afghanistan. In addition, I understand the chambers will regularly hold consultations in order to eliminate factors impeding bilateral trade and economic cooperation. We will promote the foundation of joint ventures in order to attract investment and promote economic cooperation between both business communities, between Afghanistan and Telangana. The theme that has been chosen today, peace and stability through trade and business, is essentially important theme and topic. The one who has suggested this is Kayati, I think, maybe, or other things with him. With her, so really that's that makes sense in today's context. So through trade and business, we're striving for peace and stability in the region, and that's how we can witness progress and prosperity, economic development, and a better life for everyone in the region that we are concerned about. So I wish you all the best, and hope this is the beginning of furthering and expanding trade and business and furthering connection and ties between the people of Telangana and Afghanistan. So I'm very thankful to all those who participated in this event and seminar. And I'm very thankful again to FTCCI for organizing the seminar and event. And I look forward for future cooperation. The Consulate General of the Islamic Republic of Afghanistan is at your disposal at any time, any question, any support you need that will be provided. So we are very grateful to the support that has been given so far to us by the FTCCI and also by the government of Telangana, especially our dear, dear friend, Excellency, Mr. Jayarangan, who has always stood beside us in any situation we needed his support. So thanks again to colleagues, friends here for being here, and congratulations for this great achievement for signing this memorandum of understanding. We hope to make some good achievements of this and progress from now on. Thank you so much for your attention.
Thank you, Your Excellency. I now request our chief guest, Mr. Jayesh Ranjan, to address the seminar.
Very good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. His Excellency, the Consul General, Mr. Mohammed Suleiman Kakar, Mr. Bhaskar Reddy, Mr. Rajendra Agarwal, Mr. Anil Agarwal, Mr. Shafiqullah Atai, senior members of ACCI, office bearers and members of FTCCI, senior officers from the consulate, greetings to all of you. I would like to convey my congratulations to both the FTCCI and ACCI for taking this very important step today. And I would like also to compliment the consulate and their office for facilitating this partnership. This is indeed a very important partnership. Typically, when we think about Afghanistan or when we talk about Afghanistan, there is a belief that we should design our programs or interventions as a matter of humanitarian aid or as a matter of charity. But there is also a very strong business case of engaging with Afghanistan. In fact, a few months ago, the consulate, Honorable CG, had organized a 7 days, a week-long event in which Afghanistan's products, their services, their culture, their cuisine, all that was showcased. And it was very amazing to find so many opportunities of engaging with Afghanistan completely on merits, completely on business case, without thinking of Afghanistan as a war-ravaged country or a country which requires help and support. That may be there, but there are, we need to go beyond that perspective also. So I'm very happy that this partnership agreement has been signed, and to both the parties, to FTCCI as well as to ACCI, I would like to suggest a framework in which this partnership can be operationalized. So my suggestion is in three parts, that let us look at opportunities of trade and investment into three buckets. The first way to look at it is look at all the products which are imported in Afghanistan. Afghanistan, I'm sure, produces some of its requirements, but a large number of their requirements are also met from other countries, imports from other countries. And I'm sure that lots of imports from India also go to Afghanistan. But what we can do is to check which are those products or services that can also be exported from Telangana by Telangana companies. And can we offer a better quality product? Can we offer a less costlier product? Can we improve our specifications, better delivery, reliable delivery, certain other offerings along with the main product? So let us see if there are any possibilities by looking at, let us say, the 50 most important imports to Afghanistan. And if they are not from India, they are not from Telangana, can we outcompete others? So this should be the first bucket. The second bucket is something which is going on in our country itself for the last about a year or so. In our country, as many of you would know, a campaign is going on, which is called Atmanirbhar India or Self-Reliant India. This has been started by our Prime Minister, by the national government. And the logic is something similar. Whatever we are importing, can we manufacture it domestically? And at the national level also, the government has identified some of the bigger items of imports. And then the idea is to convince local manufacturers to manufacture it here itself by giving incentives, etc. So in the context of Afghanistan, this second bucket will be to see all the products which they import, and can someone go there itself and manufacture? So obviously the cost of logistics, import, duties, et cetera, will come down. And of course, when you are going and starting to manufacture there, do it through a joint venture partnership. Identify suitable Afghan companies or Afghan entrepreneurs or Afghan investors instead of doing it just by yourself. So can we identify certain items where the entry barriers are lower? There aren't too many other companies who are competing in the same space. Companies in Telangana have an expertise. One very good example can be pharmaceuticals, because companies in Telangana, in and around Hyderabad, not only have national level expertise, they have global expertise. Hyderabad based companies have done manufacturing facilities even in the US and Europe, and in so many other places. So that is one possibility, but there are various other sectors also, food processing sectors, textile sectors. So if you look at which is currently being imported, can also be manufactured locally in Afghanistan with the help of partners. So we bring technology, we bring knowledge, we bring part of investment, but there is a local partner who participates in it. And most importantly, jobs are created locally. So that will be the advantage which we can offer to Afghanistan. And the third bucket, of course, is to promote more and more market access to Afghan products. As I mentioned in the exhibition which the consulate had organized a few months ago, that was the main purpose. There were lots of handicraft products, there were carpets, there were jewelry, there were dresses. Most importantly, there were processed food items like dry fruits and so many other things which were there on display. So how do we improve their access to Telangana, to India? Can Telangana become the gateway for the entire South India? So there are lots of FTCCI members who are into trading, into export and import. So how do we help more and more producers in Afghanistan or artisans in Afghanistan to create to get access to better market opportunities in Hyderabad. So this three-pronged, three-bucket approach, first, to send more products to Afghanistan, which they otherwise also import at a more competitive terms. Second, to consider manufacturing some of those products there itself with the help of a local partner. And third, bringing more and more Afghanistan's products into our country. And one other possibility, I mean, this can be called as 3A, that whatever you are bringing from Afghanistan, can some value addition happen here? You bring it in some semi-finished or raw state, do the value addition here, and so that the returns are higher to that kind of a product. So various possibilities are there. And I guess FTCCI and ACCI together should think of what will be the most feasible way of taking this partnership further, because I'm really excited at this partnership. Normally, we sign lots of MOUs and they remain confined on paper. Nothing much happens as a follow-up, but I'm very confident because I know that Mr. Bhaskar Reddy has just taken over Mr. Agarwal. The new team is very proactive. Earlier also, when Mr. Ainani was there, Mr. Bhaskar Reddy also was taking lots of initiatives and guiding the Federation. So under his leadership, and as I mentioned, the CG himself is very, very kind of agile about opportunities. He's here to make a difference and not just while away his time. And I have seen it in umpteen occasions. So I'm confident that this will go really fast and this will go much forward. And as the government, we'll be very happy to facilitate any aspect of this partnership that you take, you want to take forward further. So my good wishes to all of you, and thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Jayesh Ranjan ji, for your valuable inputs, and definitely FTCCI will take it forward, your inputs, and will work together with the ACCI and the dynamic leadership of our Consul General and take all your inputs further. So thank you one and all for joining. I now request Mr. Anil Agarwal, Senior Vice President FTCCI, to propose vote of thanks.
Good afternoon. It is my privilege to propose vote of thanks to Mr. Jayesh Ranjan, IAS, Principal Secretary, Industries and Commerce Department, Government of Telangana, His Excellency Mr. Mohammed Suleiman Kakar, Consul General of Islamic Republic of Afghanistan, and Mr. Safiqullah Atai, CEO, Afghanistan Chamber of Commerce and Investment, for sparing their valuable time and addressing this seminar for the development of business relations between India and Afghanistan. The FTCCI is very happy to collaborate with Afghanistan for furthering the tie between the two countries for the development of business, particularly with the state of Telangana. I am happy that sir, Telangana is, FTCCI is 105 years of its journey, and Afghanistan Chamber of Commerce and Investments, they are also into their 90 years of their journey, service to the industry and commerce. I'm confident that participants must have benefited with this seminar, and opportunities which we see in the Afghanistan, we should grab that opportunities and take the full benefits of this seminar. I thank all the managing committee members, past presidents, members of the FTCCI, government officials, and officials from the Consulate General for participating in this seminar. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you. We'll have a group picture. Vice Consul from this. Mahati. Thank you. The ACCI representatives, they are virtually there. Members, if they have any query or what they would like to export, import from Afghanistan, maybe they can ask, and the ACCI representatives, they can answer to those. The floor is open. Mr. Jayesh Ranjan, he has to go for some urgent meeting, and maybe the interaction can we can continue here. Anybody would like to know more about the Afghan, what they export, what they import, or maybe anybody interested in?
If I'm allowed to make a point here.
Yeah. Yes, please.
Is it on?
Yes.
Well, actually, I really appreciate the three practical points suggested by His Excellency Jayesh Ranjan, that I think from now on, we must take those three practical points into consideration very seriously. And the first one, he spoke about what are the products that are being imported by Afghanistan, and not only from India, but other places. So India can substitute other exporters in the region or other places, because Afghanistan is very keen to furthering its tie with India compared to other places. So if it is competitive, and I'm sure it will be, so Afghanistan can be a great market for the products from India, especially Telangana. So we have to assess and see the list, what are being imported into Afghanistan, that the ones that is not being exported from India to Afghanistan, that can be taken into consideration. The second, products that can be exported from Telangana, and also maybe the joint venture, the things that Afghanistan and companies from Telangana can support the companies there with the incentive that's been decided by the government of Afghanistan. So this will be a kind of an import substitute products for Afghanistan, and to produce in a joint venture with the companies by Afghanistan and India there. So that's more about investment there in Afghanistan by the companies from Telangana and jointly with the companies in Afghanistan. And then access to market, we have to think of what can be consumed here, or can Telangana become a hub for further adding values to some of the products from Afghanistan here and export it either to other countries or to the region itself in southern states. So there are other possibilities. I think we have to take these suggestions very seriously into consideration. I think it's a homework for both our Chamber of Commerce there in Kabul and also the Chamber of Commerce here in Telangana to work together on that and prepare and share that information with companies, enterprises, from the business community. And then that will be very easy to start from there and in a very practical manner. So I really appreciate that practical point suggested, and we will be doing follow-up on it also. So Mr. President, I think this will be our homework as of now, and Mr. Shafiqullah and his colleagues, a homework to take into consideration on that aspect. Sometimes people just think about import and export, they remain limited to that scope. But actually, Mr. Ranjan, His Excellency Mr. Ranjan, Jayesh Ranjan, broadened the scope of what might be possible in terms of business. So believe me, if Afghanistan whole become the production, will have the production capacity of dry fruit or other products, to bring it here, it will be consumed very easily. But that would not really help the growth of economy or business. In one sense, it can, but the real and practical terms, what will benefit both is the three practical points suggested by Mr. Ren.
Thank you, Your Excellency. That's a wonderful suggestions taking for advice of Mr. Jayesh Ranjan. What we'll do, so we will communicate to all our members and prepare a kind of a dossier, like who are all in the exports of the concerned products. And we'll do some homework. And also, I request Mr. Shafiqullah Atai also to do the same, like do some kind of a scan in the in your members, the possible exports or possible collaboration opportunities, and we'll communicate each other. That's the way we have to begin. So, and then from there, we'll take forward. So in maybe in a month's time, I'll be able to communicate from our end, and I'll expect the similar kind of a response from your end. Thank you.
Can I organize a webinar again?
Yeah, once framework is there, we can organize one more webinar where people can participate from both the chambers virtually, and then exchange their views, and we can do some connect, like matchmaking kind of thing. Thank you. Any other questions from anybody? I think we'll be able to answer. Thanks.
Hello, this is Janakiram from ISM Corporation. We are into pharmaceutical exports to various Asian countries. I had personally been to Kabul 2 months back to see the scope of business over there. The concerns were there from our perspective as to find out a distributor, a reliable distributor. And I also went across the country to the, up to Jalalabad and other areas as well. Went to, saw the market, there was a good scope over there. The concern was the particular reliable distributor over there for our pharmaceutical product. The second is the surety of the revenue coming back. These are the top two concerns of from our side. So is there anything that HCCI can do for us to handle to such to facilitate this situation?
Yeah. For your kind information, I'm sure my colleagues there in Kabul will also have duty on it. Recently, there was a presidential decree limiting the work of those pharmaceutical companies in Kabul, instead of having a very large number and not reliable, not to the standard. So by limiting the number, I mean, giving allowance or the permission and license to very limited companies that have a very good reputation and are competent and in every aspect, and they guarantee. So I think in that sense, you can easily now find the reliable partners by the list that has been become squeezed in terms of those companies, because there are many operational but not effective, not to the standard. So perhaps Mr. Atai is there again, and his colleagues may update on that.
So we will be happy to sure. Get a list of those, people who are interested over there, and exactly. We'll if that. That can be recommended, it'll be very
that
easy.
Can be done.
Just like UPCCA, periodical that publication, if any, if it is to be circulated among the members, that could give you a better understanding and way.
Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. I'm Mirza Arif from Sarif and Company. We are into export of agricultural commodities and many more things. What sources we have, we are able to export to many countries. Whenever we try to locate the serious buyers, it will be very hard to find. I request the Excellency to assist us as possible as you can do to see that serious people come forward and take our inquiries and do some serious trading between our country and your country. Thank you very much.
Yes, obviously, indeed, we will support you in all of that aspect, Mr. Arif. We will connect you with the reliable sources who are interested in import of agriculture products. There are already agriculture products being imported in Afghanistan from India. So my colleagues there in Kabul will also help us finding the reliable partners. So you can accept the steps we talked about is in practical terms to do the matchmaking webinar and seminars to help the revenue boost of the potential to support by number of companies. I think individually in the past, people did some of those kind of businesses that didn't work well. So if there is a level of guarantee on the top and there is an assurance from the Chamber of Commerce that is problem here, and as also present in that whole scenario, then it limits the risk of failing in some of those business deals.
Yeah, I think Mr. Atai would like to talk.
Yes, Mr. Atai, please. Unmute yourself.
And just disrupted for some moment the connection. Regarding the question that has been raised by one of our colleagues over here, since the price was not that much clear, if I get it right, once anyone we are looking for reliable partners in Afghanistan in any business, if you are looking for such reliable people and business people, first of all, they can approach to ask the ACCR. Or either if they find someone as their
partner. There is a echo out voice from your side.
No, it's okay. Yeah, please go ahead.
First of all, it's better to approach us, and if they send us an email, we have everything set it over there on our website. We're going to have an MOU or some agreement, business agreement between this particular person who is claiming that he is an Afghan business person. Is he qualified and eligible or has that capacity to work with or not? Because it's very sensitive and important for us as ACCI. While we're connecting the business people, we're trying all possible assurance to make sure this particular person is going to be work with one of our friend and business person over there in India, is the reliable person. If I got your question rightly, this is our point. ACCI has any mechanism in the ground, definitely you can approach to us. And we are welcome to give you all the details and information about that specific question. And even we can provide you with the number of or the volume of export that particular half-run trader has in our databases. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. Got it. So, we will do the same, like what Mr. Atai is telling. Validation is important from their side. So whoever business houses who want to partner and align or export, import, whatever. So the validations can be done through the Chamber of Commerce, and we'll write to them and understand. So they are also like to have the confidence in the local trader, because they may be also having some doubts about the external partner, whoever is coming. So their authenticity and all that. If it is passed through the chambers, some kind of assurances will be there for both of us. So that comfort, they are looking at it, and certainly we'll provide that comfort. Thank you.
Thank you.
That's it.
all these business transactions and all that, they will be routed to the chamber only. Even for attestation also, chambers are authorized. But here, that is not the case. So a sort of support from the government, that is done, that validation would have its own.
Right. Thank you. We'll formally close the session, and at the tea break, CG and his team will be available, and the interaction you can continue. That. Thank you, one and all, for joining this program. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
We have a virtual webinar on insurance industry, changing dynamics in risk management and value proposition, and officials from the IRDA member and his GM, and one from the United India Insurance Company, they will be speaking on the insurance industry in the COVID, what initiatives they have taken. So members who are interested, they can stay back here, and we'll have a virtual session on the insurance industry. Thank you. Yeah, 4:30 it will start.